A century ago, a majority of people in the United States lived in homes that they built themselves. The owner had to build considering current needs, what his family required at that time to successfully live life every day. But he also had to think about the future. Would his family get bigger and require more space? Would his family's needs change? Meaning he needed to design the house to be able to meet those changes. For nearly 40 years, Lexington Regional Health Center has been that owner, building for our community, our family, adjusting to serve the current healthcare needs of our patients while always looking to the future and what our community will one day need to ensure their needs will always be met. As we gather this evening to build a brighter future together, we wanted to share three patient stories that illustrate our passion for the absolute best care for the community in which we live.
Who's going to give you any better care than your neighbors?
My dad couldn't ask for better care for his son.
If it wasn't for the care of the nurses and the doctors here, I would not be here today.
They represent our approach to every patient who enters our facility. They are our family. A family we are proud to serve. Like John Wilson of Cozad, whose health quickly began to deteriorate after injuring his shoulder and later developing severe pain in his neck.
He couldn't move very well. He just couldn't get comfortable because of the pain. His vitals was just really going wacko. His blood pressure was just crazy, and his organs was actually shutting down at home. When I called and he says, get him into emergency.
Carol rushed John to emergency care at Lexington Regional Health Center.
I don't remember a whole lot after that. The next thing I remember was waking up in the hospital a month later.
John had developed sepsis in his back, which had then entered his bones and turned into septic shock. He was placed in a medically induced coma while spending the next month at a hospital in Lincoln. When John returned to Lexington Regional after his infection had started to clear, his real recovery started.
I couldn't imagine where I would be without this facility right here. They saved my life, is what they did, no matter what I needed. I mean, when I first got out of bed, I could take like two or three steps. By the time I left the hospital, I was making laps around the center of the hospital there. So the nurses always gave me encouragement. I've been in other hospitals before, and the personal touch is not there. It's like family, is what it is. You know, they treat you like family.
They were just awesome with him, and he's not the easiest person to take care of.
John says he's not back to 100%, but almost to 88, which isn't bad considering the odds he was given when he was originally diagnosed.
They gave me a 4% chance of living, a 4% chance. And if I did live, they gave me a 98% chance that I'd either be brain dead or paralyzed. I gotta give thanks first to God. And then the nurses, the staff, the doctors, they all took care of me. And I would not be here today if it wasn't for them.
For longtime Lexington resident Steve Atwood, it wasn't a life-threatening illness that required the care of Lexington Regional, but daily knee pain. Simply walking had become hard labor, and a double knee replacement was the only solution.
You have a little anxiety when they're going to replace two knees, and just being able to have the surgery in your hometown is great. You still get the same quality surgeons, and who's going to give you any better care than your neighbors or your friends? So that takes a lot of the anxiety out of having a major surgery like that.
It's just a real comfort factor to think you can be at home and get excellent care.
The surgery was a success, as was the intense physical therapy required of the recovery.
They shouldn't have allowed me to do the water therapy because that's all I wanted to do after that. And I highly recommend it to anybody that has that done. I just had much better results. I couldn't be any happier with the people over in the physical therapy area. They were able to cope with a big crybaby, and so that that was wonderful.
2 years later, Steve says his knees continue to get stronger, which means an easier lifestyle both at work and play.
Let's walk towards the toys, he says.
Most importantly, he received the most essential part of patient care during his stay.
They were able to get the Nebraska football game on while I was there. And what was even more impressive was I had some of the nurses come watch it with me. Now, how much better can that possibly be?
Well, I'd say that kind of sums it up, doesn't it?
For me, it does.
The anxiety of medical treatment is magnified tenfold when it involves a patient with Asperger's syndrome, one of the autism spectrum disorders. For Caden Schaefer of Grand Island, it was dental work that just wasn't possible through traditional methods. Caden's dentist recommended the work be done at Lexington Regional while Caden was under anesthesia. His dad, Earl, says the procedure would have never been possible without the support of the hospital staff who took special care of his son.
The experience was just phenomenal. They didn't act like it was a job as much as it was just more or less a family positive atmosphere. They made him a Mario balloon to try to calm him because he did get a little excited. And one of the nurses, he says, "What is your favorite thing?" And he said, "Well, I like Mario." And he still has it. But that was just the kind of people they were. They you know, opened an arm, welcomed him. They didn't make it feel like it was a burden to have him. That was the best experience I've ever had in my life.
The staff was even able to clip Caden's nails while he was still under, helping his parents complete another challenge when he is awake.
I was just really impressed with how everything went, being that Caden has special needs and can be hard to deal with. It was just a very smooth procedure the whole day. They have the patience, the courtesy, that you just don't find anymore. I mean, a dad couldn't ask for better care for his son.
Building a brighter future begins with patients like John, Steve, and Caden. Providing life-saving care, offering specialists to support a better lifestyle, and providing a customized experience to make every patient's stay a positive one. Lexington Regional Health Center is proud of our service to this community and excited for the future as together we build for the future needs of our friends, neighbors, and family.